Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up multiple users in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. One of the benefits of QuickBooks Online is the ability to give other people access to your QuickBooks data. Most commonly, this is used to give your accountant, bookkeeper, or tax professional access to your data. This allows them to log in, see your business and financial data, and do your bookkeeping for you from their office without having to bother you. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. First, we will walk through the steps to give your accountant access to your QuickBooks data. QuickBooks allows you to invite up to two accountants to access your QuickBooks data. To begin, let's click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name, and we're going to select Manage Users, which is located right below Account and Settings. We're going to go ahead and set up an invite to send to our accountant. So in the lower part of the screen where it says accounting firms, we want to go ahead and click on the blue invite accountant button. And here you want to enter your accountant's email address. We've also got a field here to enter your accountant's name, but it is optional. After you send the invite, your accountant will receive an email that contains a link for signing into your QuickBooks Online account. In addition, your accountant will be asked to create a user ID before signing in for the first time. Until your accountant signs in, their status on the Manage Users page is invited. After they accept the invitation, their status changes to active. By default, your accountant will be given company administrator privileges for performing tasks like closing your books for prior periods. Be sure to give your accountant a heads up that you have sent this invitation. It's possible that the invite could go to their spam or junk folder, so be sure to have them check there as well. If you need to resend the invite, I will show you how to do that from the Manage Users page. So let's go ahead and select Next, and then Finish. On this page, you can manage the invites that you have sent. So as you can see, we have the updated now invite that we've sent to the accountant. The status is invited. Once the accountant accepts that invitation, that status will change to active. And if for some reason the accountant does not receive the invitation, then you can also resend the invite from this page as well by clicking the resend button. While you can certainly benefit from giving your accountant access to your QuickBooks data, they may not be the only one you'd like to share your account with. For example, you may want to share your data with a business partner. You might also want to give your tax professional access to your QuickBooks data so he or she can obtain financial reports that are needed to prepare your tax return without you having to drive over to their offices or run the reports yourself. Once you have decided who to give access to your QuickBooks data, then you need to decide what information they need access to. QuickBooks allows you to grant limited access to users who do not need to see everything. A good rule of thumb here is to give folks access to only what they need and no more. Let's walk through the steps on how to give other users access to your QuickBooks data. At the very top of the page, you're going to see the Manage Users section, and this is where we want to go ahead and create those additional users. Let's go ahead and click the New button. From this screen, the first step that we need to take is we need to select the type of user. There are four types of users here: regular or custom user, company administrator, reports only, and time tracking only. So let's talk about the regular or custom user. For this type of user, you can select which areas of QuickBooks to give this person access to. This is great for someone who does not need access to everything in QuickBooks, but just specific areas. For example, a bookkeeper whose only responsibility is to manage accounts receivable tasks like invoicing and entering customer payments does not need access to any accounts payable tasks. The next user type is the company administrator. The company administrator has access to all of your QuickBooks data, as well as any additional services that you may have through QuickBooks, such as payroll or payments. This level of access should be limited to decision makers only, business owners, partners, or officers of the company. The third user type is reports only. You can give reports only access to someone who does not need access to anything else. For example, if you have a tax professional who you see annually to file your tax return, this access would work well because they can run any reports that they need, for example, income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement to complete your tax return. And finally, the time tracking only user. In the advanced lesson, we walked you through how to set up tracking for contractors who need to report their billable hours. To access this course, click here. The time tracking only user is perfect for contractors because they only need access to QuickBooks so that they can report hours that they worked and nothing else. So we're going to go ahead and set up a bookkeeper who manages accounts receivable for Paul. So we'll select the regular or custom user option here and click next. There are three types of user access rights that you can set up in QuickBooks Online. We've got the all access rights, no access rights, and limited access rights. Let's start out talking about the all access rights. All access rights will give the user unlimited access to all of your QuickBooks data. A list of what the user can do and cannot do is listed on this screen. The only access that is not included here is administrative rights. We will cover administrative rights a little later in this lesson. No access rights is the complete opposite of access rights. This level of access does not include access to any of the QuickBooks data. However, it will allow this user to manage other services that you may subscribe to, like payroll and payments. The only access that is not included here is administrative rights. The third type of access rights is limited access rights. We'll talk about the limited customer and sales access rights first. Limited customer and sales access rights allow you to grant access to just customers and sales. You can see a list of what this user has access to do and what they can't do on this screen. This will be the level of access that we would give to the bookkeeper that we discussed earlier, who is just responsible for accounts receivable tasks like invoicing and entering customer payments. If you do need someone to perform any of the tasks listed under what they can't do, you will not be able to select limited access for this user. Instead, you will have to grant them all access rights so that they can perform these tasks. We will go ahead and select vendors and purchases. So the limited vendors and purchases access rights allows you to grant access to just vendors and purchases. You can see a list of what this user can and cannot do on this screen as well. This would be the level of access we would give to a bookkeeper who is just responsible for accounts payable tasks like entering and paying bills. If you do need someone to perform any of the tasks listed under what they can't do, then you will not be able to select limited access for this user. Instead, you will have to grant them access to everything in order for them to be able to perform these tasks. So for our bookkeeper, for Paul, we are going to grant that person limited customer and sales access rights. So we'll go ahead and make that selection, and then we'll click next. Setting up users' administrative rights. In this step, we're given the option to grant administrative privileges to a regular or a custom user. This is not applicable to the reporting only or the time tracking users. I do not recommend that you grant administrative rights to anyone who is not an owner, officer, or partner in the business. The reason is anyone who has administrative rights can make several changes without your permission. One, they can add or delete and change access rights for all users. The second thing they can do is change company information, like company name and tax ID. And last, they can add new services or cancel your QuickBooks Online subscription. You also have the right to give this user view-only access if necessary. So we'll go ahead and make our selections for our bookkeeper user. Once you have made all of your selections for access rights, we are ready to go ahead and send the email invitation to this user as we did for our accountant. So on the next screen, we'll go ahead and enter the email address as we did before. Entering the name, as we mentioned before, is optional. Similar to the accountant, once you send the invite, the new bookkeeper will receive an email that contains a link for signing into your QuickBooks Online account. The new user will be asked to create a user ID before signing in for the first time. And until the new user signs in, their status on the Manage Users page is invited. After accepting the invitation, their status changes to active. Be sure to give the new user a heads up that you have sent this invitation. If they don't have you saved in their contact list, then this invite could go to their spam or junk folder. The great news is you do have the option to resend the invite if they do not receive it from the Manage Users page. So we'll go ahead and click Next and then Finish. That will bring us back to the Manage Users page, where we will see the update for the bookkeeper invitation. And again, here, the status of the invite is pending and the user has been invited. That status will change to active once the bookkeeper has accepted the invitation. And then the resend button to resend the invite is also there if you need it. And that's it. That wraps up the section on how to set up multiple users in QuickBooks Online. To access this course or any of the others in the series, just click this link. For a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.